Hi everyone, I'm Grahtles, and welcome back to a new episode of Satisfactory. No, this is not the Best Start series, but it has to do with the Best Start series. So anyway, I'm going to show you how to use the website Satisfactory calculator to your advantage. So here we are, I have a ton of belts with this belt system inside our factories, and I want to upgrade these from a 4 to a 5. And that would take me forever. So that is one of the things we're going to do with the satisfactorycalculator.com, as well as I'm going to show you how to import and export some buildings and how you can find resources on your maps and different things like that. So let's go ahead, get in and get started. All right, so here we are at satisfactorycalculator.com. And there's so many things you can do with this website. There's planners, there's an interactive map, game resources, blueprints, whole bunch of stuff. But the one we're going to look at today is the interactive map. So if we go down here, you can see there's a lot of pop-ups. Yeah, you need ads to kind of make money when you make websites like this. And sometimes they're surrounded with ads. They could be a little annoying, but I totally understand because this is an amazing website. So anyway, here you could see there's layers for the maps. There's different layers. You could see the heights and different things that go around them. It's just incredible. Right now it looks like Artifacts is on with Mercospheres. And we also have some nodes going on with Limestone. But anyway, you can find pure nodes, impure nodes, normal nodes, just by clicking on the map, and you'll know exactly where they are, and you can find them way easier. There's collectibles like the hard drives, food, artifacts like your summer sloops and your mercospheres, and power slugs. So yeah, this is a very, very powerful, powerful website. But anyway, we're going to go back to this layer here. So anyway, if we go to the top here, it says click or drop your save file here. So I'm going to click that. And if you don't know how to get to your save files, I'm going to show you. So if you go to C and then users, mine is Grahtles, but it would be with whatever your name would be. And then app data, local. And then you scroll down to factory game. And then saved, and then saved games, and then this 76561 blah 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 blah. We're gonna double click in that, and then we're gonna go to the save we want to upload. So mine is going to be cleaning up after bauxite. That was I cleaned up some stuff after I did my last episode, and I named it that so I'd know exactly where I was at. So it takes a little bit to load, not too much, and now it's absolutely amazing. I'm going to zoom out, and you're going to be able to see everything on your map. Everything you've done, and then I could actually take off those limestones. Let me see if I could do that now. Probably not, it doesn't really matter. Is there a way? Yeah, here we go. There we go. So you could unselect all layers. So now you could just see what you have going on. So you see I have the map listed here, like pure oil. I have the black powder. These are all the little map things I put on here. This is the train that's going in pink. That's a railway. I've got the oil that I done up here. The coal I did here. This is our bauxite over in here. And over in here is the other oil we did. But anyway, we're focused on our main hub right in here. So I'm just going to zoom in a little bit. Now I want to upgrade all these belts. Some of them are still threes, and some of them are fours. See here, you got some threes. That's from some of our iron. And the main thing I want to upgrade is our belt system. Those are all fours, and I want to make them fives. So I'm going to select everything in this area and I'll just upgrade it to either a 4 or a 5, and I'm fine with that. I could go around and upgrade the rest later on if I want to. So I'm going to select the rectangle tool, and I'm just going to make sure this gets everything I want in this area, and then I'm going to do that. So this says you have selected 22,179 items, and you can see it'll say mark 4, mark 4 lifts, mark 3, mark 3, and that's okay. I'm going to scroll all the way down, and it says delete selected items. Absolutely not. We don't want to do that. What we do want to do is we want to go ahead over to downgrade, upgrade, and upgrade selected conveyor belts and lifts. And then I'm going to submit that. So now when I scroll over, well, if I can come down a little bit lower here, you'll see mark 5, mark 5, mark 5. All of these are mark 5 belts now. Now, there may be some glitches sometimes where some of the belts don't upgrade, but, you know, go around, take a double look, triple look, make sure everything's upgraded. These up here should be mark 6 because I believe I did put these in with a mark 5. I will delete those until we are absolutely ready for mark 6 because I don't want to be cheating. It will give me some of the stuff. Yeah, see here. But that's neither here or there. The video is about upgrading your lifts and your belts. So anyway, now that you've gotten that done, you're going to go back up to here. And there's a download button. But before we do that, I want to show you how we can copy a building and save that into the same save. Now, you can do this in any save as far as moving the building. So you can change the upload of the save and still be able to put that building into any one of your saves. So let's go ahead and take a look. So I've had a couple of people asking me about this iron building right here. Now, it's not exactly in a great shape to actually import because of the fact that my foundations are different heights. So when I lay this down on a new foundation, it's actually going to be all different heights because really what you should do is delete it to the ground floor or a little bit even, and mine's going to be completely uneven. But that's okay. We're going to still show you how to do it. So I'm going to grab this rectangle tool and I'm going to grab it from about here and I'm just going to pull it across to, yeah, about there. That should be fine. And again, you get the pop-up and here where it says delete selected items. Again, we do not want to delete, but we want to make a mega print. So I'm going to hit copy selected item and I'm going to hit submit. So now what I want to do is I want to import export Megaprint. So I'm going to download the current Megaprint. So there it is. It's a second one because I had a first one of this. So we'll just open up our downloads. As you can see, it's right here. We're going to go into downloads and here it is right in here. I'm going to close that out. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to a part of the area here. Where's a good foundation? That's not too far away. Right over here, I have some foundations laid out. So I'm going to do import export and I'm going to click drop Megaprint here. I'm going to go to downloads and I'm going to grab it. And it says import 2,181 items from Megaprint. Don't forget to paste it in its original location or by clicking on any foundation. So we're going to right click on a foundation and I'm going to paste 2,181 and I'm going to submit it. So there we have it. It's really close to our train lines. It's fine. It's just for showing you purposes. So anyway, now that we've done all that, we now have the upgraded belts. We have a new building. We're going to go up to the top and we're going to press download save game. Now, if I wanted to do anything else more, I would do it before I downloaded it. Otherwise, I got to upload it, download. Yeah, it's crazy. But anyway, now that I got everything I wanted to get done, I'm going to download this. And it's going to tell you, it's going to save it with the appended calculator after the regular file name. So I'm going to save the changes. So there it goes. It downloaded a new save game. So basically where I showed you your save games before on how to pull it from there, you're going to put this in the folder instead of extracting from the folder. So I'll show you how to do that. So anyway, I'm just going to pop this up. I'm going to go to C, Users, Grahtles, App Data, Local, Factory Game, Saved, Save Games, and 765. Next, I'm going to open up another folder in Downloads. So here we go. We have Clean Up After Bauxite Calculator. So let's go ahead. I'll show you. It's not in here yet. So there's the one right there. We're going to go ahead and dump it here. So it ended up on the bottom. That's fine. Next, we're going to close out of this and start up the game with that save. All right, so here we are, and it's Clean Up After Bauxite, right here with the calculator at the end. We're going to click on that one and load the game. All right, so here we are in our game. I just don't want this to get dark. I'm just going to use that. But anyway, let's see. This is all Mark V belts. Let's get over to our belt system. And we'll scoot down. And as you can see, Mark V, Mark V, all the way up is Mark V. The lifts, they are all Mark V's. So it upgraded all our lifts and belts. We're gonna go over to the back end of this where we put the iron factory, which, like I said, is not in the best shape and not in the best spot. It doesn't really matter. I'm just gonna go over there anyway to show you that I imported it. So yeah, we're inside this building. I didn't leave ourselves enough space. It's fine. You can see it imported the whole building. So the building is here, the machines are here. In fact, everything on the outside here on the belts is in here as well. And yeah, that's how you import and export a building as well. So yeah, that's going to conclude today's episode. And what I'm thinking is, if you like the iron building, which is a lot of why people have come and joined my Discord to try to get a mega blueprint, and it's not really a blueprint, but you can take it from my Discord if I make a copy of this. Obviously, I would have to clean up the bottom and make sure I put it in here properly for you. But anyway, if I do that, you could take the blueprint, put it into your world with the satisfactorycalculator.com website, and you'll be able to use the iron factory. Like I said, I don't know if all the belts are upgraded. Like, it's fine. But if that's what you would like, I would definitely do that for you. Feel free to come on over to the Discord. And I must thank AJ. He is one of my subscribers, as well as he joined my Discord. And he was actually looking for the iron factory, and I did not have that on here, and he gave me the idea to actually make the video. So I made the video on it, and I will put this into the Discord once I get it all cleaned up and everything. So if you like my content and you want to see more, like, subscribe, comment, share, and yeah, we'll get on with the series after this episode. So thanks for watching. Bye.